Hey everybody, what's up y'all? Welcome back to my channel. Tammy Talks here. Let's go ahead and talk Married at First Sight Season 14, Episode 6, Dark Side of the Honeymoon. If you're brand new to my channel, I do breakdowns of various TV shows, both scripted and reality, including Married at First Sight, where I give each couple their own dedicated video each week. So if you enjoy that type of content, go ahead, subscribe to the channel, thumbs up the video, hop into the comment section, because it is just always a lot to talk about with Married at First Sight. So let's talk Lindsey and Mark, y'all. So they wake up together after their fight. So Mark went downstairs and he apologized for the dinner. He understands that he handled it wrong. He said he committed a sin and he's asking for her forgiveness. In Mark's eyes, he was planning a romantic dinner and to kind of let her know where he was. It came out wrong. It was executed poorly. I watched the after show last week and Lindsey said, I was thinking Mark, and Lindsey said that they had had sex 3 times that day, including right before they had dinner. So she was completely blindsided by everything that happened, and that's why she kind of reacted the way that she did. So Mark apologized. They decided that they have so much in common. They're compatible. They really want to make their marriage work. So they decided to let bygones be bygones, and they head back upstairs to go to bed for the night. Lindsey said to her, intimacy is having a fight and then moving past it. She said that she thinks they have great communication, and that's why they're able to have an argument, talk it out, and then move past it. I said, for now y'all do. So the next morning they are at breakfast. They pray, and Mark then asks her about church. Does she go to church? How does she feel about church? He thanks her for praying, because even if it wasn't something that she typically does, she did it for him with no problem. She says she grew up Greek Orthodox, super, super traditional. She wants to raise her kids in church. She wants them to grow up in church. But once they're old enough to make that decision for themselves, she wants to allow them to do that. Mark is okay with that. He said, that's cool. So they start to talk about kids since Lindsey brought it up. She says she does not want 1 or 3, so apparently no odd numbers with her. Mark said he wants to have as many as he can afford. If he can afford children, he has no problem having, I'm assuming it's not going to be like a crazy amount, but as long as he can comfortably afford them, he's cool with having them. So Lindsey then tells they make an agreement that if they have a set of twins, then they are done. That'd be a one and done for them, and they both shake on it and agree. Great conversation, right? So then we get this montage of Lindsey talking to in a confessional, and she said that Mark's mother and his landlord has been calling and texting all day and night. So apparently in Mark's building, there are bed bugs. Now, I was confused about this, y'all. I was confused. So, are they saying that the bed bugs were in Mark's apartment or like an outbreak in the building? I was confused by that. I honestly and truly was. I didn't understand where they were getting at with that. I just didn't get it. So, but apparently his mother has been calling all times a night. She said it's hard for them to kind of get to know each other because they're constantly being interrupted. And we see like even when they're asleep, when they're waking up, no matter what they're doing, his mother is calling and texting like crazy. And then on top of the fact, he's having a situation with his landlord. So they go on a little massage date so that they can kind of relax and unwind. Marcus had a morning. So apparently Mike's situation with his landlord has gone from sugar to shit. So, which is crazy because I think they were saying that his landlord was like a mother to him. Yeah, she was at the wedding. She's like a mother to him, but she has changed his lease and said that he now cannot have cats there. So now he has to move. So now I'm wondering, Mark, now did the bug situation happen in your apartment and it spread? And that's why? Like, what is really going on here? So Lindsey said that she went into mama bear mode. And I wanted to say, mama bear protects the cubs, not the daddy. But whatever, girl. And she's telling him that he can just move into her house. She's like, so Monday when we get back, we're going to go to your place. We're going to clean all that shit out. We're going to handle the bed bug situation. And then we are going to move everything into my house. Now, this is what got me. She's not saying move everything into the new house. She's saying move all your stuff into her house. Do y'all know if y'all will be married after this? After these 8 weeks, are y'all going to still be married? I would take a little caution with that, Mark. I would think that you should get a storage locker, find a friend that you can put your stuff in, like their attic or basement or something like that. But I don't think moving everything to Lindsey's house is the best idea, personally. That's just me, but I don't think that's the best idea. So Mark said that it's kind of weird for him because even though this is his wife, this is his responsibility. He feels like this is his situation. This all falls back on me. So he is like a little he doesn't know how to deal with it. He's used to dealing with everything by himself. So while he loves that she is, you know, vibing with him and she wants to take care of him, he's still just he's a little uncomfortable with it, to say the least. So we then see the whole group dinner. They're all talking about what's going on with them, you know, the typical last night dinner that they all have on the honeymoons. Well, even though there were a lot of people around that table laughing and kind of making faces when Alyssa was talking, Alyssa made a point to call him out. I mean, to call Lindsey out. And she does not react. And Mark is happy about that. So he tells her, you know, I'm happy that you didn't get into it with with Alyssa. You didn't bite, you know. She singled you out personally because she doesn't like you, but you didn't take the bait. You didn't fall for it. So he's proud of her for not doing that. And she was like, yep, just doing what you asked. Doing what you asked, because she doesn't want, you know, Marcus already had to talk with her about minding your own business, staying cool, not getting into it with everybody the way that, not getting into it with everybody the way that you possibly could. So I'm very interested to see what is going to happen with them. We see next week on the episode when they're moving in, Lindsey has said that Mark is like living with two different people because kind of his life is falling apart. So I'm wondering if it has more to do with just his mother and that whole situation. I'm sorry, if it has more to do with the bed bug in the apartment situation, and if it has more to do with like his mother. Is his mother sick? Is his mother like demanding more? And so she feels like they like it's two different people. So I don't know what's going to happen with that. Oh, I forgot to mention. They met up with Chris. And when Chris was telling them what's been going on with Lindsey, I'm sorry, what's been going on with Alyssa, Lindsey just kind of told him, look, this falls on her. You know what I mean? She's going to look up in 10 years and kind of feel like she made a big mistake. She's going to regret everything that she did to you. One, because of how it's going to make her look on TV. But two, she's going to realize that you were right for her. You were a good fit for her. You were good for her. Like, y'all were matched for a reason, compatibility-wise. And yeah, I know we say that the experts matched them off of superficial things. But there might be some points in each other's personality that are matched together for a reason. And Mark kind of even told, like, in the confessional, was like, Chris is going to have to... You got to choose. You got to pick yourself. You have to choose yourself. You can't keep going through this cycle of kind of chasing after her and putting up with what you shouldn't put up with. I always find it comical how these couples give each other advice. Y'all were just fussing and fighting yourselves literally the night before because you told her you didn't want to have, you didn't want to be lovey-dovey with her and y'all need to rein back. But now y'all think that y'all are okay to give advice to Chris. I always cringe when these couples give each other advice on their honeymoons. Because on one side, you're only getting Chris's side of the story. While Chris's side is true, you're only getting Chris's side of the story. And it, we start to see who like just likes who better. I will say Lindsey was very chill. It doesn't seem like she had too much to drink this episode. So maybe that's why. But who knows? If you have not already subscribed to the channel, thumbs up the video, hop into the comment section, and check out the other videos from tonight. Every couple got their own video aside from Steve and Noi because we saw them in like a piece of a scene. Other than that, I will catch you guys in the next one.